So, students, we discussed the assumptions of valence bond theory and some points which are related to valence bond theory. Now, let's discuss the bonding and magnetism of various complexes on the basis of valence bond theory. So, let's begin with some example. First, we will start with the tetrahedral complexes with sp3 hybridization. Tetrahedral complexes with sp3 hybridization. The first example we are discussing now, it is a structure of NiCl4 2 minus this complex. Now, in this complex, how we can describe the structure? The first point, it is a given complex, it is NiCl4 2 minus. You need to write down first. Second point is, which is the central metal ion here? It is Ni 2 plus. Now, how you can find out the oxidation state of metal if the complex is cation? Then it is very easy to find out the charges present on central metal ion. In most of the cases, the charge, positive charge, which is present on the metal, present on the complex, is the charge on the metal ion. But here in NiCl4 2 minus, how we can find out the charge present of Ni? It is, suppose in Ni, then there is Cl. How many Cl are there? 4. And the total charge, it is minus 2. So, for Ni, we will take x. For 1 Cl, the charge is 1 negative. So, for 4 Cl, the charge will be 4 negative. So, x minus 4, it is equal to minus 2. So, x is equal to minus 2 plus 4. So, x is equal to 2. So, what is the oxidation state of nickel here? It is Ni 2 plus. As here it is 2, so we can write down 2 plus. So, in this way, you can find out the charge or the oxidation state of central metal ion. It is Ni 2 plus here. Now, number of ligands. In this complex, 4 chlorine are attached to the nickel. So, number of ligands are 4. So, and nature of ligand. Now, as I already told you that all halides, they are weak ligand. Chloride, it is a halide. So, it is a weak ligand. Then, next point is electronic structure of central metal ion. Here in this case, Ni is the central metal ion. Ni, which is converted into Ni 2 plus. Okay. Ni, its atomic number is 28. So, let's begin how we can find out its electronic structure. Now, the atomic orbital configuration, electronic configuration of Ni 28. It is argon 18, 3d8, 4s2 and 4p0. There are no electrons in p orbital. 3d8, 4s2, 4p0. Now, the electronic configuration of nickel atom, it is written in box diagram like this. 3d8, 8 electrons are arranged like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6, 7, 8. So, there are 3 paired electrons and 2 unpaired and 4s2, 4p0. So, 3d8, 4s2, 4p0, it is written in a box diagram like this. Now, in NiCl4 2 minus nickel, it has plus 2 charges. So, the electronic configuration of Ni2 plus ion, that means we need to remove 2 electrons. So, 2 electrons are removed from s orbital. So, now the electronic configuration will become argon 18, 3d8, 4s0, 4p0, because 2 electrons are removed from s orbital. So, the box diagram for Ni2 plus, it is 3d8, 4s0, it is also vacant, and 4p0 was already vacant. Now, to this nickel, 4 chloride ions are attached, 4 ligands are attached, so it require 4 empty orbitals. These empty orbitals, that is 4s and 3 4p orbitals, they undergo hybridization. In this hybridization, as 1s and 3p orbitals are involved, this hybridization is known as sp3 hybridization. Once nickel, it forms 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals which are empty. Now they are ready to accept the electron from 4 chloride ions or 4 chloride ligands. The chlorine, 4 chlorine, they bring electrons and they are donated to the empty metal orbitals which are shown by red color. So, in this way, NiCl42- is formed by sp3 hybridization. So, we can write down hybridization of central metal ion in NiCl42-, it is sp3 hybridization. Then, shape of the complex, as it is sp3 hybridization, shape is tetrahedral. The structure of NiCl42-, which is tetrahedral, it can be written like this: Ni, central metal ion, and 4 chlorine atoms are present at the corners of tetrahedral structure. The electronic configuration or bonding representation is like this, which we already discussed. Now, in this bonding representation, you can see that NiCl42-, it has 2 unpaired electrons. So, from these, we can say that the value of N, it is equal to 2 here. From these, we can calculate the magnetic property of NiCl4. Since chloride ion, it is a weak ligand, thus unpaired electrons are not paired. Lone pair from 4 chloride ions are accommodated in 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals, and number of unpaired electrons remains 2. As there are 2 unpaired electrons, this complex, it is paramagnetic, and its magnetic moment is calculated by using spin only formula, that is square root of n plus 2. The value of N, it is 2 here, so it becomes 2 plus 2. So, the total value, it is square root of 8. And finally, we get the value of mu, magnetic moment. It is 2.828 Bohr magneton. So, in this way, we can discuss the structure of various complexes. Now, during the formation of NiCl42-, Ni2+ provides 4 vacant orbitals, that is 1s and 3p orbitals, and undergo sp3 hybridization. Hence, it is outer complexes. Means, all the orbitals which are involved in sp3 hybridization, they are present outer side, not inner complex. It is a outer complex. Now, let's begin with the next example, MnCl42-. So, again we will start point wise, given complexes MnCl42-. metal ion, central metal ion here, again it is Mn and the charge present on it, it is 2 plus. How to calculate? I just explained you. Take X for Mn, then for 4 chlorine, it is a minus 4 and the total charge present on complex, it is minus 2. So here X is equal to minus 2 plus 4. So the value it comes x is equal to 2. So the charge present on central metal ion, it is plus 2. So we are getting here Mn 2 plus. Then number of ligands, 4 chloride ions are there, so it is 4. Nature of ligand, again it is a halide, so it is a weak ligand. Now electronic structure of central metal ion, Mn, its atomic number is 25. So its atomic orbital electronic configuration is argon 18, 3d5, 4s2, 4p0. The electronic configuration of Mn2 plus ion, we need to remove 2 electrons as it is 2 plus. So we are removing these 2 electrons. So it will become argon 18, 3d5, 4s0, 4p0. Now chloride, it is a weak ligand. So all these unpaired electrons which are present in d orbitals, 5 unpaired electrons, they do not undergo pairing. If strong ligand is there, then unpaired electron, they start pairing. But chloride, as it is weak ligand, no pairing is done here and there are 5 unpaired electron, they remain as it is. In Mn2+, there is vacant s orbital and vacant p orbitals. These 1s and these 3p orbitals, they undergo hybridization and there is a formation of 4sp3 hybrid orbitals. These 4sp3 hybrid orbitals, which are vacant, they accept the electron from 4 chloride ions, which are shown by red colors, and there is a formation of MnCl4 2 minus ion. Now during this formation of this complex, you can see here there are 5 unpaired electrons present. So the value of N here, it is 5. N is equal to 5. So what is the hybridization of central metal ion here? It is sp3 hybridization. Shape or geometry of the complex, it is tetrahedral. As it is sp3 hybridization, the shape will be tetrahedral, which can be represented in this diagram. You can see it is a tetrahedral structure. The magnetic property. Now here you can see how we can calculate the magnetic moment. Here there are 5 unpaired electrons are present, so the value of N, it is equal to 5. The value of magnetic moment, it is square root of 5 plus 2. So it is a square root of 35. So the value of mu here, it is 5.916. And another thing is, in MnCl4 2 minus, there are 5 unpaired electrons and hence it is paramagnetic in nature. Here also, in MnCl4 2 minus, Mn2 plus, it provides 4 vacant orbitals, that is 1s and 3p orbitals, and it undergo sp3 hybridization and hence it is a outer orbital complex. Remain another examples of tetrahedral complexes, we discussed only 2. Another examples are these. All these complexes, these are tetrahedral with sp3 hybridization. Remaining part we will discuss in next video.